Agnieszka from Violet Sky Plans. Welcome back to my channel where I share my ideas on how to creatively plan your life, budget and meals. If this is something you're interested in, please make sure to subscribe. In today's video, I'm planning in my horizontal weekly planner. I'm using these floral books. I'm actually using two of them, not only one. I like the book that much that I've actually bought two of them. So before I've just started filming, at least you discovered the pattern which is in the middle. I was using this spread for past few weeks, and I did have a problem with with the pink pattern in the middle. So I've just completely covered it. And in this video, my idea is to actually use the flowers, those purple flowers from floral books, in the middle. I've never actually done it like that. I was thinking about covering patterns like that, but those flowers are quite big actually. So yeah, we'll see how it goes. So as you can see over here, I've chosen my main sticker, and I'm just about to commit to it and just just placing it carefully in there. And oh dear, can you see how misaligned is that? So yeah, I've just noticed that as well. So we'll see. Well, after cutting it, actually the difference is not that bad. I think it looks a bit better than I was expecting it. So I will leave it like that. Also, I will be using more of the florals, and also I would like to try to cover the pink box on the side. So what I'm doing at the moment, I'm just choosing the more purple flower from those books, just to cover the middle. I'm kind of deciding how big flower should I use. After that, I'm just gonna use another small one from the same book, but it's not enough. I'm not about sure about this one. Why I'm checking that? Because the stems from the bigger stickers, it looks like they will be on the leaves from the other sticker as well. I'm not exactly sure if I like that, if I like how it looks like. So I've used the bigger sticker. That sticker is the same as the one which is placed already. It's just from the other book. But I've decided that this big sticker will look better over the pink box. So I'm using the bit smaller sticker which I've chosen before. So yeah, I'm trying to place it fairly straight, a bit straighter than the previous one, I guess. I kind of left the stems on the very end, but you know what, I don't actually dislike the view of it. I think it looks better than I've thought again. So yeah, let's keep it like that. I tried to use the smaller flower on the top, but it was a bit too big, so I'm choosing even smaller now. This one, I think this will do. So yeah, I've just decided to use this one. So yeah, I'm happy about that. So I just need to cut, and hopefully there'll be nothing weird there. Oh, and that's it, we're done. So now I need to cover the pink box, because if I wouldn't do it, it will be coming through the stickers, because they're actually on the clear paper. Looking at the floral stickers, I prefer them on a clear paper, but obviously there's a minus of that's paper underneath needs to be white. Yeah, I love this sticker, it's just beautiful, isn't it? I was just, to be honest, I was holding those stickers for quite a while. I had those books for quite a while and I did not use them. I just kept looking at them and I just could not make myself to use it. Now I'm just gonna cut the edges of the sticker. I'm gonna save them. When I'm cutting the stickers, when I'm using stickers like that, I'm really trying to use every single piece of the sticker, even like the really small ones. I just don't like the idea of wasting stickers if I can use them. And I just don't actually have an idea what to do with it, so you're gonna see in a moment. I'm kind of trying to place it, where will be looking okay. And now I'm looking for the colorful boxes. So I kind of thought maybe I'll use the green one, but actually didn't have the right shade of green, nothing similar to the leaves on those stickers already. So I decided to use a kind of pink, maybe purplish instead, and I'm covering the horizontal line, because I am a bit of pedantic when I'm doing my spreads. I don't like those lines being visible underneath the stickers. And I've just put the offcuts from that previous flower. I actually really like how it looks like. I like how it turned out. So you know, so even the pieces of sticker which you're cutting off and you know, and you could think that could be thrown away, that actually could be used as well. So I need to use small boxes in the other places. So again, I'm looking for little flower to go with the box. The box will be just a bit bold, I think. So I'm gonna put them on over there. I'm gonna put them together. I think they look quite nice. And I try to place the fairly straight. Again, it would be quite annoying for me if the sticker would be not straight at all. And nope, it's not straight. So let's move it by tiny millimeter or something. So okay, so now looks better. I'm happy about it. So now I've got that hole in between the middle and the flower on the right. So I need to do something with that as well. Don't have enough flowers for that. So I'm looking for some kind of leafy black bushy kind of flower plants or something. So yeah, so again I'm kind of fairly fast moving through it. Sometimes I'm placing them like that is a bit easier. As you can see, I'm using wax paper quite a lot. I'm one of those planners which I'm not really decided where I want to put something. I need to kind of see it. I cannot really visualize how to put something, how something will look like just before I place it. I kind of have an idea as what I would like to do with the sticker, but I'm not exactly sure. I need to kind of like try to see it before. Well, this wax paper is, you can see, he used quite a lot, so yeah, he's used quite a lot. Yeah, so I think I'm kind of decided on the view. I do like it. That big flower, I think we're gonna go there just to cover a different side, because I've just used, when I've put the stickers on your one side, it doesn't look like it's enough, the other side doesn't look right. So I definitely want to use the stickers on the other side as well. So I'm trying to find exactly the pattern for it, and yes, I found it now. So that's it. It's almost there. Oh dear, it's thick and I didn't like it. So let's try it again, and that's it. And again, I will have a bit of offcuts on the side, but that doesn't bother me at all. I will try to use them if I can. I'm usually trying to keep those like long boxes which I have for either my to-do lists, for like some kind of general, for like week to-do lists. I don't have to do them on some specific day, or like some kind of like important reminders which will be standing out. But also, you can see over there, I'm kind of like covering Thursday, most of the Thursday. So like I don't mind, but usually I'll try to actually avoid it. I would like to have Thursday to write down, but I would probably use the box, which is the long box, just to do some to-do list probably for Thursday. Also if I've got an to-buy list, I like having some separate box, quite visible box for it. So I'm just actually looking for more boxes now, because that doesn't stand out for me. On Friday I've got an appointment, so again I like it to be kind of visible. Oh, what I did not like about this sticker, there was something what I did not like, so I just took it from there. Ah, okay, I know what I didn't like. I just don't think I had enough of space for that shape which I'm just trying to create from two boxes. I thought it would just look quite weird, so I thought I was gonna add this one instead. And also I'm covering the lines again, because they're visible underneath the sticker. Not, you know, not badly. Some people will be not put off by it at all, and you know, they'll be not covering all the whitening out the parts. But yeah, I am bothered by it, so I was always trying to do it. Okay, so I think that kind of look okay, but I still have the leftovers of the plants, of the flowers. So I'm kind of thinking maybe I can still use it. So I'm just trying to find some space for it, and I think I kind of found it straight away. Kind of yeah, it was just there, it was just needed there. Yeah, so and again I've got like tiny bits which I'm thinking, oh, what to do with them. There's like a little dot, green dot, and I'm trying to put it in some kind of blank spaces really, just to fill it in better. Again, I like it where I've put it, so yeah, I'm just gonna leave it in there. And I've got one more, I've got like a really really small one, and I'm kind of thinking again, you know, I could use it now, or I could just put it back to the book and just use it for the other occasion when I'll be using similar flowers. But if I can use it with the spread I'm doing, I'm just trying to. And yeah, I like it at that. I think they look more natural. It looks like a part of the flower which is on the top of that box for on the right side. So I do kind of like it how it looks like. So that's my finished spread. I hope you like it, and if you do, please come back to my channel, please subscribe, and wait for my next video. See ya, bye bye.